So while the threat of a large asteroid hitting Earth isn't imminent or even likely, it is possible. NASA and other international space agencies want to be ready to protect our planet should that threat ever become a reality.
Yes, and today the first ever mission to intentionally crash a spacecraft into an asteroid came to an end. KCRA 3 meteorologist Heather Waldman joins us. So Heather, sounds like the plot to a movie, but this is real life.
I had the same thought when I first heard of it. Yeah, this project is known as the Double Asteroid Redirection Test, or DART for short. The idea, as Lisa and Ty just said, crash a spacecraft into an asteroid going at about 150,000 miles per hour to knock it out of its orbit with a second larger asteroid. The DART spacecraft was launched just under a year ago from Vandenberg Space Force Base in Southern California. It traveled hundreds of millions of miles on a collision course with a 500-foot wide asteroid called Dimorphos. Well, that collision finally happened just about 15 minutes ago. And joining us now is Elizabeth Gabeler, who was on the team that helped design the DART spacecraft. Elizabeth, I just watched the collision happen in the newsroom. You just watched it as well. How do you feel?
I am so overcome with emotion right now. I never thought this day would come. I started working on it 5.5 years ago. I was there present for the launch, and that was exciting. And just watching it and seeing the photos of the surface of Dimorphos was just a surreal experience.
Yeah, so of course, as we watched it, of course, once it made collision, we lost the imagery. So when are we going to know if this experiment worked and did what we hoped it would do?
We should be able to see some results as soon as tonight. We've got a bunch of ground-based telescopes around Africa and South America. They're going to be monitoring to see if they see any changes in orbit. But we've also got a small satellite flying behind DART along with Hubble and James Webb Telescope that are supposed to be imaging the impact and the after effects of it.
So this was the first of its kind mission to intentionally crash a spacecraft into an asteroid. I assume there's a lot more planned in this sort of defense strategy. So what is next in the mission to protect Earth from these large asteroids?
Right now, the Planetary Defense Office is going to see if this worked. We have to make sure our calculations were correct, that Dimorphos and Didymos behaved as we expected. And from there, they can start doing more calculations of if asteroids of certain sizes, how big of a spacecraft do we need, how fast does it need to get going. Once we get the results from DART, we should be able to start planning and designing more missions and be prepared in case an object came at us.
And one thing that really stood out to me, this asteroid was 500 feet in diameter, hundreds of millions of miles away. How is it possible that scientists knew the trajectory to get the spacecraft to collide with this asteroid?
So we've got a lot of ground-based telescopes that have been monitoring Didymos for several years, but DART also has navigation systems on board and was able to track the stars. We were able to estimate the orbit, and then when it got close enough, it was able to lock onto Didymos and do its own corrections to be able to meet up with it.
Elizabeth Gabeler, thank you so much for joining us and sharing your enthusiasm for this project.
Thank you.